At the time of my recording this message, it's Sunday the 1st of November. Many of you will know the significance of this day. It's the Feast of All Saints. We'd normally attend Mass as a school community on this day, but the Solemnity of All Saints happens to fall on a Sunday this year, so hopefully you would have managed to go to Mass at your local parish with your family. But even if the feast day didn't fall on a Sunday, and it was in one of the school days, because of the various restrictions on year group mixing, it would mean that we wouldn't be able to gather as a school community. So I wanted to share a short message with you and for us to share a moment of prayer together at the beginning of your PSHE lesson this morning. Now, as you already know, our school is called All Saints Catholic School. And that's a title that you probably hear too much and ponder too little. What does it actually mean to belong to a school which is under the patronage of all the saints? Well, when I was a child, I went to St. Joseph's Primary School in Dagenham. Some of you may know that school, you may have even gone there. But that school is under the patronage of St. Joseph, the one saint, in fact, my favourite saint. My local parish was St. Vincent's in Becontree. Some of you may know the church. Further up the road in Goodmayes, we've got St. Sed's, where I used to go for daily mass. We've also got St. Thomas More, St. Peter's and Lyons, St. Bede, St. Mary's and Hornchurch, and many more schools and churches that are under the patronage of various saints. And I keep using that word patron or patronage, and I think it's worth taking a moment just to think about what that means. Because patronage, or that word patron, it's not like Patronus, which is a creature from the Harry Potter series that's conjured up by some strange spell. A patron, as defined in a dictionary, is a person who gives, and this is the bit I'm going to read out to you so that you know the definition, a person who gives financial or other support to a person, organisation or cause. So a patron is someone who provides support in various ways. So when we think about our cause as Christians, we can summarise that quite simply. Our cause, our real purpose, is to become saints. Now that might shock you, and it might not be what you want to hear first thing on a Thursday morning. Like, Sir told me that I have to be a saint. But yeah, that's our cause, and we have to be bold about it. To prove to you that that's our cause, and that's actually something you probably desire, I had a Year 9 class, and after we did the start of lesson prayer, I asked them a simple question. I said, out of curiosity, how many of you in here want to be saints? And I had about 3 hands go up. Then I said, okay, I'm going to ask you a question. I'm going to ask it differently. How many of you in here want to go to heaven and spend eternity with Christ? And at this point, everyone's hands went up. And that includes some of the non-Christian students. It's like, what a great offer. I'd go to heaven if I could and be there forever. It's a great deal. Now, I went on to say, okay, so how many of you in here want to become holy and want to be holy? And for this question, it was like half the class said they want to be holy. So it's a tricky question. One boy, when I asked it, I mean, he had his hand up. He was like, yeah, I want to be holy. And then he kind of slowly put it down. He was like, and I said, why did you put your hand down? And he said, well, it's because it's just too hard. And I said, okay, it is difficult. You're right. It's not easy to be holy. But desiring to be holy is actually the first step in actually becoming holy. Now God has something to work with, doesn't he? You've cooperated with the Holy Spirit. So the next question I have to ask the students, and I want to ask you this morning, is how badly do you want to be holy? Is it something you want just a little bit, or is it something you want a lot? Is it nothing to you, or is it everything to you? Because going to heaven and being with Christ, it means that you are holy. The saints who went before us were the ones who made holiness their priority. And at our school, we have all of those holy saints, men and women, to be our patrons. They support us and they support our cause, especially when it's a righteous one. So some people think that as Catholics, we worship Mary and the saints. We don't worship them. They're not Almighty God. We honour them because they're holy men and women who are now in heaven with God. They won their crowns. They made it. They fought the good fight, and they received their just reward in eternity. We here on earth, we're still in the fight, we're in the race, and they support us as we go along. To help you understand this, I'm a big Arsenal fan, and please don't react, okay? Just accept it, we're the best team in England. But anyway, I'm a big Arsenal fan, and I had the privilege of going to the Emirates Stadium to see my team play in the Champions League. And I remember when the players walked out onto the pitch, there was a crowd of about 60,000 fans, and they were all cheering in support of them. It was something quite spectacular, whether you're an Arsenal fan or not, seeing these players, these 11 men that are on a pitch, supported by 60,000 people. It's quite an awesome sight anyway. And it was quite dark and all the lights were on, and it was brilliant, it was amazing. And as the match went on, it was like every good block that they put in, every tackle, every free kick we won, every corner, everything that the team did which was good, we supported them, and you can see that they were taking strength and encouragement from us and from our support. So life is actually a little bit like that. The saints, and they're like the ones who are in the stands. They've made it to heaven and they're cheering us on. Every good deed you do, every holy communion you make, every act of charity, every kind deed in your family, they look down on us and encourage us, and there are so, so many of them. The Bible actually teaches us that we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, so we're not alone in this struggle to become holy. And sometimes at school, students ask me to pray for them for various things, and it's normally around exam season though that I get these requests. It's like, sir, please pray for me, I've got my exam coming up. And I'm always happy to do it, but I have to be honest, sometimes I forget and I feel really unworthy. But before I forget, what I often do is I entrust that prayer to a saint. So if, let's just say, Dave comes and asks me, sir, will you pray for me? I'll be like, okay, St. Joseph, please pray for Dave. Or St. Michael, please pray for Dave. So I entrust it to a saint because they have much more power before God than I do. Now, if a limited man like me can pray for you, like, how much more greater will the prayers and the intercessions of the saints be? They can pray on your behalf. You see, God is our eternal Father, and the saints are like brothers and sisters who have gone before us. They've got to God's kingdom already. They're cheering us on from the kingdom of heaven. They're willing us forward, and they're hoping and praying that we will join them there. So if there's one thing I want you to take away from this short reflection this morning, it's to be courageous, really have courage, set your sights on God, become a saint, be holy, stay in the good fight. And with that, I'll finish, and I ask you to bow your heads and let's pray together. Please bear in mind, prayer is a communication with God. We're speaking to Almighty God. He's the creator of heaven and earth. It's not just a feel-good, send-me-good-vibes type moment. This is real. It's tangible. This is speaking to Almighty God. And we'll do so in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God, the Father of heaven, we thank you for our school community and for our education. Lord, may your love always abide here, and may we remain one in Christ. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, together, I'd like to share an ancient prayer with you. I wasn't sure if I was going to do this or not, because it is quite long. But all you need to do is say the response, which will appear on the screen. The response actually has the letter R before it, so you know when to join in. Now, I know you're in your various classes, but let's share this moment of prayer together. This prayer is a special prayer. It's called the Litany of Saints. It's just a fancy word for list. And I sometimes think to myself, prayer can be long and boring. But instead, let's change the narrative. Let's not see it that way anymore. Let's see prayer as something serious and worthwhile. And this is a serious prayer. So let's begin. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Holy Mary,
pray for us.
Holy Mother of God,
pray for us.
Holy Virgin of Virgins,
pray for us.
Saint Michael,
pray for us.
Saint Gabriel,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael,
pray for us.
All you holy angels and archangels,
pray for us.
Saint John the Baptist,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
All you holy patriarchs and prophets,
pray for us.
Saint Peter,
pray for us.
Saint Paul,
pray for us.
Saint Andrew,
pray for us.
Saint James,
pray for us.
Saint John,
pray for us.
Saint Thomas,
pray for us.
Saint James,
pray for us.
Saint Philip,
pray for us.
Saint Bartholomew,
pray for us.
Saint Matthew,
pray for us.
Saint Simon,
pray for us.
Saint Jude,
pray for us.
Saint Matthias,
pray for us.
Saint Barnabas.
Pray for us.
Saint Luke.
Pray for us.
Saint Mark.
Pray for us.
All you holy apostles and evangelists.
Pray for us.
All you holy disciples of the Lord.
Pray for us.
All you holy innocents.
Pray for us.
Saint Stephen.
Pray for us.
Saint Lawrence.
Pray for us.
Saint Vincent.
Pray for us.
Saint Fabian and Sebastian.
Pray for us.
Saint John and Paul.
Pray for us.
Saint Cosmas and Damian.
Pray for us.
All you holy martyrs.
Pray for us.
Saint Sylvester.
Pray for us.
Saint Gregory.
Pray for us.
Saint Ambrose.
Pray for us.
Saint Augustine.
Pray for us.
Saint Jerome.
Pray for us.
Saint Martin.
Pray for us.
Saint Nicholas.
Pray for us.
All you holy bishops and confessors.
Pray for us.
All you holy doctors.
Pray for us.
Saint Anthony.
Pray for us.
Saint Benedict.
Pray for us.
Saint Bernard.
Pray for us.
Saint Dominic.
Pray for us.
Saint Francis.
Pray for us.
All you holy priests and Levites.
Pray for us.
All you holy monks and hermits.
Pray for us.
Saint Mary Magdalene.
Pray for us.
Saint Agatha.
Pray for us.
Saint Lucy.
Pray for us.
Saint Agnes.
Pray for us.
Saint Cecilia.
Pray for us.
Saint Anastasia.
Pray for us.
Saint Catherine.
Pray for us.
Saint Clare.
Pray for us.
All you holy virgins and widows.
Pray for us.
All you holy saints of God.
Pray for us.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world.
Spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world.
Graciously hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Happy Feast Day, all saints. Have a brilliant day.
Hello, I want to wish everybody a happy feast day at All Saints.
Happy Feast of All Saints to everyone in All Saints School, especially those Year 8s who have been working so hard.
Happy Feast of All Saints.
Happy Feast of All Saints, everyone. Have a good feast day and enjoy your celebrations.
Mr. Odin. Happy Feast of All Saints, everyone. Hope you had a great day.
Happy Feast of All Saints to all the students at All Saints.
Happy Feast Day, everybody. Enjoy.
Happy Feast Day, everyone.
We wish you a happy feast day, students at All Saints.
Happy Feast of All Saints.
Happy Feast Day, everyone.
Happy Feast of All Saints.
Happy Feast of All Saints.
Happy Feast Day from all of us in CAD.
Happy Feast Day, everybody.
Happy Feast of All Saints.
Thank you. Hi, folks, Mr. Thorne. Happy Feast of All Saints. Have a great day.
Happy Feast of All Saints, everyone, especially here in Everton.
Feast of All Saints.
Hey guys, Miss Switzerland here. Have a great feast day of All Saints today. Enjoy yourself. Bye.
Happy Feast of All Saints to everyone.
Perfect. Have a great feast day, everybody. 2020, bring on 2021.
Happy All Saints Day.
Happy Feast of All Saints.
Happy Feast of All Saints.
All right,
okay.
I can't say it like this time. Just show me laugh, right?
Just say Happy Feast of All Saints, everyone, especially to Year 11 or whatever.
Okay.
Happy.
Go for it.
Happy.
The amount of people that have done that. Happy Feast of All Saints.
How's the hair? How's
beautiful,
the hair?
Beautiful.
The hair is perfect. Go. <Yeah. laughs> Right. Yeah, when you're ready, Happy Feast of All Saints. Very good, you look very sharp.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, if you want.
It's All Saints Catholic School! Happy Feast!
Boys, don't do that.
So, shall I put this in the bloopers?
What am I doing? Happy
Feast of All Saints.